Hey everyone, this is Travis the Tau Templar. Today I want to talk about a failed subnet, how it worked, why it failed, and why the failure is actually a good thing. It was called the healthcare subnet, Subnet 31. It lasted a few months in early 2024. The goal was to create an open source AI that could be given a CT scan image, and then have an AI diagnose patients given that image. Miners were responsible for training the AI. There was a public data set that was simply a mapping of image to diagnosis. There was about 100,000 of these mappings for miners to train on. Validators rank ordered the miner's loss, which is a way of determining how good an AI is at its task. They then distributed rewards based on the loss of miners. Each miner was training their own individual model. The models were public in that as long as you had the link, you could download the model. Validators had access to that. So validators would download the models that were being trained by the miners and then run it against a private data set of image to diagnosis. They then rank ordered the miners based on how well they did against that private data set. The subnet made a few improvements while I mined on. For a while, miners could get rewards just by having a low loss. It was exploited by some larger miners who had been training their AI for weeks and then stopped training their model and received rewards even though they had stopped working. The subnet owner fixed this by making sure miners had improved their models every time rewards were distributed. Some miners then shared the same model across multiple miner keys, thereby receiving more rewards for doing the same amount of work. So the subnet owner changed it so that models had to be unique. Each model was siloed. Miners couldn't see each other's models, and therefore there was a lot of work that was repeated. So it wasn't proper parallelized training. The miners that had been around for the longest had a ridiculously huge advantage over newer miners because they had been training up their models for longer. Miners that had started in January would always receive more rewards than those that had more recently started in March. As a subnet owner, you don't want this. You want every single miner contributing to the overall intelligence of your subnet. Instead of having the new ones constantly repeating old work and not contributing anything. The owner was also not active on Discord, leading to many unanswered questions. Documentation was often outdated and incomplete, so getting answers in general was very difficult. In the end, validators and their stakers didn't believe in the subnet anymore. The subnet failed. It became the least performant subnet, and Subnet 31 was replaced by a new subnet. I did love the vision that the subnet had. An open source AI for helping diagnose patients would be immensely valuable all over the world, from poorer countries to rich countries. Being able to give an image to an AI and have it spit out what it thinks the diagnosis is, maybe with a percentage confidence, would be very helpful for places where there's very few doctors. It would fundamentally change the world, I think. I hope somebody can pick up where the previous owner left off. After all, the code is open source, and I hope they can improve upon it and make the training truly parallelized. I'll tell you a quick story. There was a miner that reached out to me on Discord for help getting started with mining. He was very interested in healthcare and had access to a non-public data set that he could have used to train on. It consisted of many, many images, and he could have been a very successful miner thanks to his special sauce. He is an example of how powerful Bittensor is. It incentivizes anyone in the world with any special sauce to come and help improve the products and services Bittensor provides. In the end, even though I was a miner, I'm glad the subnet failed. It deserved to be replaced by a valuable subnet. One of the many reasons Bittensor is so valuable is that non-valuable work like this doesn't last long. Thank you.